potential weekly workout for runners. So this workout is going to strengthen your glutes and hips and involve a little core and upper back. It's super quick, but it's one of those workouts that you're going to want to incorporate into your weekly routine. I know sometimes we focus on the running and getting our runs in, and our cross and strength training sort of falls to the side. So this is super quick, super easy, straightforward, and it targets those areas that often cause running injuries. So to get started, I like to call this the single leg squat matrix. So we're going to start on the right foot, and we're simply just going to squat forward, do a forward squat on one leg, with your leg out in front of you, and squat down, and maintain your balance. So to the front, and then to the side. You want to make sure that your knee does not go over your toes. You want to make sure that you're really squatting towards the back there. So to the side, and up. You're trying to maintain your balance, but obviously it's hard here. And then to the back. And then you want to sort of cross over and reach behind you. And then up. So each time you go down, you can also bring the leg up in a running motion. So to the front and then to the side. Back. And across. And then you can obviously switch sides. So that's a great way to work the glute, to work on balance. Another one would just be a simple single leg deadlift. And so you can do this with weights or without. If you don't have weights, that's fine. You can start up with this to put your leg in a running motion. And then squat down or deadlift forward. Come up.
Try not to lose your balance.
Sometimes it helps to focus on a single spot on the floor or focus on engaging your core and balance as well. So typically you would want to do maybe 10 on each side, maybe 2 or 3 rounds of those. And those are great for glute and hip strength. So the other thing that can often be problematic for runners is your core. So this particular glute bridge pose involves both your core and your glutes. And so you can take your back with your knees tucked up or your leg and feet tucked up your knees. And then just go down bridge up. And you want the sort of the power of the glute to come from your glutes. So you're not lifting with your core, you're just keeping your core engaged. And you're not necessarily using your lower leg, you're just really trying to power up in the glute. So that's a really good one, and I think it's essential for runners. And then another one that I like to include is just a side lying clam shell. So you want to make sure that your core is engaged and your spine is in neutral. And then you just, one of the ways that you can sort of help is press down into the ground with this knee and with this arm, and then open up using what some people call your back pocket muscle, that glute muscle right where your back pocket would be, to really lift this knee up and open. So again, you can 10 to 20 on each side is probably good for the clamshell. And then that really, those four moves really target the hips and glutes. And then the next couple moves that I like to do, just engage your core and then quick upper back workout. So probably my favorite core move that I like to do regularly is a side plank, what I call running leg. So when you get into your plank position, side plank position, make sure your body is pretty straight and your core is engaged. And then you bring your top leg up, move your top leg in a running
running motion. So this definitely makes your plank a little bit tougher. You're working on stabilization. And so then you want to do that on both sides. And then to finish off your foot little workout, we're going to do reverse fly. A lot of times runners, the arm swing really develops your chest, the muscles in your chest, and so when you're not running, your posture sort of tends to be curled forward. So you want to open up the chest and really engage the muscles in the back, because when you're running, that's going to help you breathe more deeply. If your chest is sort of curled forward, sometimes that can really hinder your breathing. So you want to roll the shoulders back and open up the chest. Don't pop your ribs out. You want to make sure that your ribs stay down. So you want to engage the core, roll the shoulders back. And then my favorite is probably just the reverse fly. So from there, you don't want to arch the back, but you do want to keep the shoulder rolled back and those ribs tucked down. And then just lift from the shoulders. Fly, the most important thing to remember is the shoulders back and the ribs not popping out. Sometimes when we roll the shoulders back, the ribs pop out, so keep those ribs sort of down, engaged. And that's really the essential moves for keeping you running strong.